Have you ever wondered how the cell culture professionals maintain such a high standard of sterility to grow the cells in vitro? If no, then today's video is for you. Hi, welcome back to my channel Absolute Biopharma. And today I am going to share with you some information regarding aseptic techniques in cell culture. So let's get started. Let us see the aim of this topic. Aseptic technique aims to exclude contamination by establishing a strict code of practice and ensuring that everyone using the facility adheres to it. Let us see the contamination type. Contamination by microorganisms remains a major problem in our cell culture. The contamination can be caused by mycoplasma, yeast, bacteria, fungal spore. The contamination can be introduced via operator, via work surface, various solutions, and atmosphere. Contamination can be minor and confined to one or two cultures. It can be spread among several cultures and compromise the whole experiment, or can be widespread and wipe out the entire stock. Some of the catastrophes can be minimized in the cell culture if the cultures are checked carefully on the microscope, if the cultures maintained without an antibiotic, the reagents checked for the sterility before use, if the media bottles are not used for different cell line, if the standards of sterile handling kept high all the time. Let us see the elements of aseptic environment. They are work surface, personal hygiene, reagents and media, and cultures. For work surface, swab the surface with 70% alcohol and only necessary items should be bought on the surface. Mop up any spillage and swab the area with 70% alcohol. Swab the surface after the use. Personal hygiene, caps, gowns and face masks required while working under the lab. No talking should be entertained while working in the lab. Reagents and media. We should ensure that they should be sterile. The bottles should be cleaned with 70% IPA before and after thawing. Cultures. Cell lines should be handled separately from rest of the stocks. It means that two cell lines should not be mixed. And the cell lines should be kept free from antibiotics. What and all are the safety precautions that we should take during sterile handling? They are swabbing, capping, flabbing, pipetting and pouring. Let us see each individually. In swabbing, the work surface should be swabbed down with 20% alcohol before, during the work, after spillage and after the completion of the work. Capping, deep screw caps should be used for the durant bottles. Screw cap should be covered with foil to protect the neck of the bottle. And generally, disposable or Nalgene bottles should be encouraged during cell culture work. Flaming. When working on the open bench, flame glass pipettes and the neck of the bottle and screw cap before and after use. Work close to the flame. Pipetting. Use of disposable pipettes should be encouraged. Mouth pipetting should be avoided. After use, pipette should be disposed properly. Pouring. Do not pour from one sterile container into another unless the bottle you are pouring from is used to be once only to deliver all its contents. Flaming is not advisable when working at lab as it disrupts laminar flow, which in turn compromises the sterility of the hood. So let's sum up this whole video in short. Here is a table showing the subject and do's and don'ts with respect to aseptic techniques. So first we'll see laminar flow hoods. In this, do's are swab down before and after use, keep minimum amount of apparatus and materials in the hood, and don't clutter up the hood, leave the hood in the mess. Contamination, work without antibiotics, check culture regularly by microscope, and in don'ts, never open the contaminated flask in lab and never leave the contaminated flask untreated. That means it should be treated with caustic or a strong base. For mycoplasma, cells should be tested regularly for don'ts, we should not carry the infected cells and we should not try to decontaminate it. Importing of cell lines, we should get the cell lines from the reliable sources. We should check for the mycoplasma contamination, we should validate the origin, and we should keep the records of all the imported cell lines. And don't get from the source far more from the originator. Exporting the cell line, we should check for the mycoplasma, we should validate the origin, we should send the data sheets for the exported cell lines. In don'ts, we should never send the contaminated cell lines as they were cross-checked by the other party. Glassware, we should always keep the autoclave stocks of the glassware separately. And we should never use unautoclave glassware for the cell culture. Flasks, the pipetting of the culture or the media should be done in the slant position. Gas from filtered CO2 line and vent should be finger loose. In don'ts, we should not open too many flasks at a time. Then the stack should not be too high. Gas in the CO2 incubator unless with the gas permeable cap. Media and reagents, only we should open the media and the reagents under the lab, and we should swab the bottles before and after use. In don'ts, we should not use the media and reagents among all cell lines. Each cell line should have their separate media and reagents, autoclaved or filtered. Pipetting, we should use plugged glass pipettes. We should change the pipettes if they are contaminated or plugged back. In don'ts, we should not use same pipette for different cell lines and should not generate aerosols. So thank you so much for watching this video, and let me know in the comments down below. I would love to hear from you what are your thoughts on this video. Make sure to hit the subscribe button because I am trying to give you the most relevant content from the biopharma field. If you want the detailed description of this video, you can comment down below. I would be happy to share the notes with you. So see you in my next video. Thank you and have a great day.